Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. New scientific reports are offering further confirmation of the importance of electrical processes in planetary geology. Scientists studying the mysterious sand dunes of the Saturnian moon Titan are reporting that electrostatic forces may play a significant role in configuring the dunes' puzzling shapes. What makes the dunes especially odd is that they frequently point in the opposite direction of Titan's prevailing winds. A Scientific American article reports the team's findings as follows. Some scientists are suggesting a shocking solution to these backward-facing drifts. They may be sculpted not only by wind, but also by electrostatic forces. A co-author of the paper, published in the journal Nature Geoscience, says of the findings, "Why do Titan's dunes look like they're going the wrong way, against the wind? One way to explain it is if the sands are sticky and don't move very much most of the time from the wind, which is what you'd expect if the sands were electrified, electrostatically charged, and clumped together. It turns out the sands of Titan should be very susceptible to charging in a unique way." The scientists believe that a number of environmental factors on Titan, including the chemical composition of its soils, its low gravity, and its minimal exposure to sunlight, all combine to produce extreme electrostatic clinging when the grains collide and produce electrostatic charge. On this series, we have long argued that electrostatic forces have shaped many puzzling dune-like features on various bodies in our solar system, including the frozen dunes of the dwarf planet Pluto and the dunes of the comet 67P. However, like the immense electrified dust devils that NASA scientists have identified on Mars, on Titan, investigators may be confusing cause and effect. What the scientists have not considered is that Titan's winds may themselves be an electrical phenomenon. Electric fields produce ionic winds, such as those found in air purifiers. And as repeatedly referenced on this series, experiments such as those seen here by Billy Elverton can produce dunes simply by applying electric fields to plates of dust and other materials. In fact, the same electrical effects that could produce Titan's sand dunes may also be responsible for other mysterious geological phenomena on the moon. Scientists were surprised to observe what they interpret as the movements of so-called putative lakes, canyons, and river valleys across the surface of Titan. NASA investigators believe that a portion of Titan's crust could be disconnected by subsurface liquids, causing surface features to, quote, slide around. But the theoretical oceans of subsurface liquids on Titan, like the Saturnian moon Enceladus, remain an unproven assumption. What is known is that the gas giant Saturn and its moons are connected by electrical currents, and these current systems may be responsible for numerous heretofore unresolved geological mysteries, including the so-called ice geysers on Enceladus. Thunderbolt's Picture of the Day managing editor Stephen Smith writes in his 2014 article, Impressions of Titan, "Titan is an electrically charged body that is constantly bombarded by intense ion beams from Saturn. It shares many characteristics with its cousin moons, Io and Europa, that orbit the planet Jupiter, a particle fountain from its poles, a toroid of charged particles in a sheath, and exchanges of massive electric charge. In a Picture of the Day about volcanoes on Io, the fact that the calderas of several, quote, hotspots moved by several kilometers in a few short months was attributed to the plasma beams that complete an electric circuit with the moon and Jupiter. Points where plasma discharges from Jupiter touch down on Io exhibit an intense glow. Similar electrical phenomena could be influencing Titan's geology. One similarity between Earth and Titan is that both planetary bodies have powerful polar winds that are said to, quote, pull gases from their atmospheres out into space. As noted in a recent Space News report, scientists have recently acknowledged that powerful electric fields play a role in the supersonic plasma jets recently discovered in Earth's upper atmosphere. On Titan and other planetary bodies, it is only reasonable to consider that electric fields may produce ionic winds, which create sand dunes and other geological features that have proved very puzzling for planetary scientists. We also predict that these features will continue to be discovered on bodies such as comets and other airless worlds, which do not have the necessary atmospheres to produce mechanical winds. It is encouraging to see increasing discussions in scientific literature of electrostatic forces playing a significant role in planetary geology. But for now, these discussions emphasize the need for all of the space sciences to recognize the undeniable significance of electricity in nature. For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.